Hey everyone, it's Sam from Sitemate. In this video, I'm going to show you how the photo section works and some best practices on how to set it up. To quickly explain the interface, I've got a populated example here. Basically, you've got your photos stored in chronological order, day by day. You've got some filters across the top here, so you can filter by date, you can filter by person, you can filter by notes and comments. And you can filter by photo tags. So to give you an idea of, you know, maybe what that looks like, if I click on a photo, we can see obviously the photo itself. We can see who took it. So I took this photo. We can see when I took it, the time I took it. We can see where it was taken. So on Google Maps, we can see roughly where it was taken, and any descriptions or comments. So if I added any comments here, I can add that to this particular photo, which means that I can search this text later on. Maybe a better example is a change reference. Maybe it's change 420. If I save that and I close this, I can now search for change 420 as an example, and then there you go. I get that particular photo. You can also search by tag. So if I click on safety, it's going to show me all the safety photos. If I click on zone one, it'll show me all the photos from zone one, etc. You can apply multiple filters at once. So I can go zone one, all right, show me the quality photos from zone one. And then, you know, maybe I'm looking for the quality photos in zone one from January last year. So I can apply a filter in here, basically apply a date range. And then I could also filter by person, and I could filter by the notes. So once you've got, you know, thousands of photos stored inside of Dashpivot, these filtering tools really do help to refine the results or the data that everyone has been uploading. In the case that, you know, there was a claim or you just wanted to go back and find something, see how it was done, best practices, things like that, you know, getting your data in is one thing, getting your data out is another, and we've tried to really optimize for both here. If you need to upload a photo, so I'll just come back to my empty example. If you need to upload a photo, you'll see this green button on the right-hand side here. If I click upload, I can either drag them from email or from my desktop in, or I can just come in and select all of the photos that I want to upload. In this case, I've got, I don't know, a dozen photos which I'd like to upload. We'll just give these guys a moment to upload. I can actually minimize that so that it uploads in the background for me. In the meantime, what I'm going to do is I'm going to set up some photo tags. So photo tags, you want to set these up basically to make the information faster to find later on. And you set up photo tags into groups. So what I'm going to do is, you know, this is my first project. I'll probably set up some tags for different functions. So I'll click this button here, this edit, and you'll see we've got, went out the settings page. If I go add tag group, it might be function. And we usually recommend setting these up, you know, for basic stuff like safety, quality, environment, commercial. Maybe you want to set up something for delays. So if you've got all your delay photos, you know, you can just tag it so you can find them really quick. Progress, you know, handful like that, not too many. Hit save, and then when we go back to our team, we will see that our photos have all uploaded now, and we've got those tags there. You know, I might set up some team tags for this particular team, you know, for the different zones that I'm working in. So we might set up a group called zone, and then we'll go zone one, or we'll go north, we'll go south and east, maybe something like that. Hit save, and then, you know, we'll set up another group for work types. And that's where, you know, you'll put in things like earthworks, drainage, what else, paving, clearing, you know, things like this. Basically the different types of works which you might be working on, we can save those in here. You might set up one for dilapidation. If it's at the start of the project and you guys are just getting started, hit save, and then you've got those there. If you're working on a building project, one thing that I would recommend is setting up tags for the different floors that you're on. So, you know, it might be floor, and it might just be, you know, level, or it might be basement, and then, you know, ground floor, level one, level two, level 3, etc. You get the idea. And this basically, again, it just makes it really easy to come back later on and, you know, filter for, you know, just level 1 or just level 2 in the north zone, you know, progress photos or delays, as an example. It just helps you really refine that information so that, you know, over time, you'll have your feed of information, you can just find stuff really quickly. If you need to apply some tags to photos, it's really easy. You just click on a photo. You see this photo already has some tags applied. You know, if we want to remove some, we can just click this X. Or if we want to add some new ones, we can then just pick from this drop-down. So it might be zone 2. We'll just apply that tag there. Maybe we want to apply another one. Maybe there was a delay. Do we have delays? We don't have delays. We'll set up, maybe it's a progress photo. So we'll just add that in there. And then we'll be able to find those photos later on. Just a note with the photo tags, particularly from, you know, if you're going to be taking lots of photos on the mobile app and or on the tablet, you know, you'll want to make sure that you don't set up too many of these tags. You know, don't go crazy and set up, you know, 100 different tags, because then it becomes really hard to find those tags and apply those tags to the right photos and keep everything neat and tidy. If you are uploading on your device, and you know, maybe you're halfway through a project already and you've already got a whole bunch of photos and you just want to upload them into Dashpivot, you have the option to upload from your device's gallery, and all of the photos that you upload from your gallery will automatically backdate. So it'll, you know, get set up like this, you know, by day, automatically. You won't have to go in and adjust any of that. It's all done automatically. So if you have any questions, the best place to start is always our help center. So you can search, you know, we've got a section dedicated to questions that people have sent through on photos, and we've done our best to sort of answer a lot of those. If you can't find what you're looking for, just click on this this button down here and send us a message using our live chat. It's really easy. That's all I've got today. Thanks for watching.